the Bible says man was created in the image of God. The Bible does not tell us whether God was black or white or Indian or what. We are God's children. We belong together.
It's now or never. Some people are actually leading you, or rather leading us, into killing each other. Now it's time that we say no to that. You know who you are. Nobody's gonna tell you what to do, because there's only one man that can give or take life, Jah the Creator.
There's been a lot of wars that were fought, and after those wars, nothing came right. It was just the killing of people. I mean, innocent people. Reggae didn't start in Jamaica, as most of the people think. Reggae and Rasta started in Africa.
Country and fans around the world are mourning the tragic death of reggae star Lucky Dube. Police are on the hunt for his killers. The musician was gunned down by three armed men in Rosettenville last night in front of his two teenage children. It appears to have been a botched hijacking.
Well, things are difficult. From having a father, one day, next day, he's gone, you know, and you were there when it happened, you know. It's kind of difficult because at times you just have flashbacks of that day.
First chapter of the Mac Chronicles. I lost my father to the wind before I could write to understand. Before I could be a man, though, mother taught us how to walk with the sun on our hands. And that blood is thicker than water for us to fight with ourselves any longer. Home is where the fire burns for us all. So look at yourself first and keep the peace at home, young soldier. Look at yourself first and keep the peace at home, young soldier. Listen to her when she speaks. Life wasn't meant to be easy even for the rich. On a table of discipline and respect, I learned the price for happiness is painful.
Ngiqala ukubona ukuthi umkhulu kangakanani ngaphandle kwe South Africa, because la South Africa I don't think ama artists athola i-exposure enough esaphila, you know, and it's only when sebeshona la ababonwa kahle ukuthi okay eish bekuyi artist elikanje elikanjeni yabona.
I mean, as you know, the song is done by prophecy. It's called Chance, tribute to Lucky Dube.
Da 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 da. So much going down. Africa felt your pain, knowing that Lucky Dube has gone. Nations cry aloud and his name I hear the echo.
Remember me in whatever you do. I love you, tell you wherever you are. Remember me.
Thank you.
gentlemen, everybody here.
Welcome, man.
Yeah, so we did it. And this is Lena.
Hi, Lena. Worm, yeah? Welcome.
Thank you. Yeah,
general. Spirit of hope, cast in greed and hate. Fate alone can decide who shall live or who will die. Caught in tides of hate, singing songs of joy, reggae songs, songs of resistance. Am I a slave, prisoner or slave? The world here, the cry is heard.
This is Prophecy.
When I came to Africa,
I keep you as manager.
I just want to, you guys, just to recognize Lucky Dube son,
yeah,
Thokozani.
Yeah.
And Uliena, who is she's worked with Lucky, she was Lucky Dube's manager, and continues to be in spirit. And here is the man of the moment. Come, stand up. The guy who did the song, it's called Chance, tribute to Lucky.
Hey, okay, Rowan Brown, from a little parish in St. Thomas, yeah, out of Jamaica. You know, we started the music early, as you know, so most Rastafari use the music as worship by parenthood. And from then, you know, we find, say, the talent of my mom spring to her and I, so I try to take it to a different levels. No matter where you come from, as long as you're a black man, you're an African. Don't mind your nationality, you have got the identity of an African. So it's a chance, we'll make it.
Something big is going to come out of this whole project. Especially that Lucky's been given a chance, even when he's no longer with us. It's actually humbling. It is so humbling.
I just want to thank all of you. I'm just hoping that we will carry the spirit of what we're trying to do, which is representing Lucky Dube's journey to Jamaica and South Africa. And I think the music video essentially is that story, is that we're trying to create a sense of connection.
Being on the set of the video, that was also another experience on its own, because Baba events are my video, right, you know, and now I know actually what happens on the set, you know.
Give us a chance and we will make it. Hey, my people, you better run, you better take cover.
Well, chance came about. Chance was always coming about and asking for it. Not myself, but you know, past musician and stuff like that. But definitely, we went to Africa 2002, and you know, awareness as black people, being from Jamaica, you know, visiting the land, we saw a necessary need for a song like this. Well, the description of the song is basically what the song is saying, you know, and looking around in Africa, in Jamaica, across the world, there is so much going down, you know. But then as Africa being a sentiment to our vision as Rastafari, you know, we had was to glorify the kind of birds that go with the song, you know.
Take a look down here in home. Problems we face down here in our own kingdom. We're even rampant in the streets of the ghetto. I'm wondering when the gunmen and the guns will go. Give us a chance to live. Give us a chance and we will make it. Give us a chance to live.
Lucky Dube was born on a farm outside Ermelo in Mpumalanga in 1964. He started nurturing his talent in the school choir. In 1982, Dube joined his first band, Love Brother. They produced 5 albums before he ventured into reggae. His first reggae album was released in 1984. Dube produced 22 albums in Zulu, English and Afrikaans, and he received numerous national and international music awards.
This is where everything started. I was born here and I grew up here, and this is where everything started happening.
Growing up without your father and without your mother, and you know, no clothes, no food sometimes, and all of that, it was a hard thing. I mean, as it was a very poor situation.
We cry for peace, perfect peace. We cry for love.
Dube, Mtimi, Mazombe, Masibekele. Owasibela ngwane ngelithuli mantime ebandla yakhethana cwaha nyamatani dludlu longadli bende wena odla maseliguca ungawadla maselithole ngisho wena abheshel nezikhwama zibi bazokhozi phuthala amabomu kuntwana elibaleka nonoxhaka umalusi inkomo ngemesidisi abanye beyilusa ngenyawo uzinjobo zigcwele i-V8 untuthwane zimnambitha amazipho esadla anhlamvana ukanakhanyi umntwana.
Why was this man killed? Why was he killed? Why? Bob Marley said one day, how long shall they kill our prophets? Why we stand aside and look?
I'm reggae. I mean, there's a song I wrote some years ago saying, you know, the bed that I sleep on is a reggae bed, and everything I do is reggae. So I mean, I'll always be reggae.
We did know that he's powerful, right? But I don't think we realized how much of an effect he had on people. You know, because to us, he was just, okay, he's a father, and that was it. Maybe you knew that, okay, yes, he is powerful to some extent, but you didn't realize it, you know, and you only get to realize it when you go to the places that he visited, you know, and hear from the people.
In a country where freedom was a distant dream, traders here say Lucky Dube kept their dream alive. Thousands died in the decade-long war which ended in 2002. And for these young people, Dube was their hero.
I feel so sad. You know, Ikolo Kidube is a famous musician, give us inspiration. So I don't feel fine about it at all.
I feel very sad because I used to love that man. He was a great man and he was doing his best.
The legend lives on across the globe.
Keeping him part of my life, you know, the fact that his music is still playing, you know, and his teachings, things he has taught me in the past, you know, lessons I've learned from him, that still keeps me going, you know, and I think it keeps anyone going.
Right now we are standing on the grounds of a very historical area in St. Thomas, Jamaica, yeah? This is where the slaves, when they didn't have hospitals and doctors, it was all like bush doctors and people boiled bushes to heal them when they get hurt. This is where they would come and do the healing process. So if a man have a cut or asthma or whatever, this is where they would come and do their mineral bath.
Okay, I'm listening. Yes, sir.
Born by our black ancestors,
Rastafari.
Yeah. And brutalized. Yeah, nice. And run away from the plantation.
Get the crown head.
Yeah.
Crown head.
Damn, that's hot. Yeah.
Hey. I'm being pampered. And you pay.
Wow. You're special, eh?
Welcome to Jamaica. It's an honor to be in your presence. We realize that even with what's taking place now, it's a happy occasion to a sad occasion, but an occasion that will strengthen you somehow. We share so much that you don't know about, but I was married to Jeff Dixon, a.k.a. Free Eye, Jasai, Rasai, Amai, Kabaka, Kafara, I, who was killed with along Peter Tosh. So even in this sense, we share so much because you were there too. I'm understanding that you were there with your father. It's fresh for you. It's just months for you. It's years for me, and I'm older. Yeah. But let me tell you, my son, that this will get better. And, you know, the Father, the Almighty, has a way of taking stuff from us that we think we can't deal with because we feel it shouldn't be at that time. Why now? You know. But he knows why, and he knows best. And maybe he wants him. Not maybe, he wants him for a special purpose.
Yeah.
So you just continue to be strong. Try and you'll never be able to reproduce or be your father. But be his son.
Yeah.
And that is what will take you through. So much blessings. God bless and guide you.
Down here in home. Problems we face down here in our own kingdom. Where evil rampant in the streets of the ghetto. I'm wondering where gunmen and the guns will go. Give us a chance to live.
Give us a chance. Give us a chance
and we will make it. Into young toes, Awuti, Matoda Awuti, Nizowood, Abantawago industry, your music, Abantuati, Nati competition, Yabab, Bonabazizwa Ranchan, Moglashela, Mokshona Gaba.
Been good.
Mr. Bird,
how are you doing, man?
Good, I'm good.
I'm great, nice to see you. I want to introduce you to the son of Lucky Dube.
Boy, that is a special pleasure.
Pleasure to meet you too.
Your dad did it for us here, you know?
Yeah.
So it's been a real pleasure.
It's a pleasure meeting you too.
And also his manager.
Hi.
Hi,
Ronnie.
Good.
My pleasure, welcome. We started Reggae Sunsplash in 1978. And you know, for the first 5 or 6 years, we kind of had all the big acts. It started with Jimmy Cliff on Third World, and then we had Bob in 79, then we had Peter Tosh, Yeah. But as we got beyond 5 years, we started to reach out for new material, new acts, you know. We didn't want to leave reggae. So we started to look around the world for other reggae acts that, you know, Jamaicans didn't know. And I don't know how Lucky's name came to us, but we said, hey, we like this guy's music. There's a similarity between his tone and Peter Tosh's tone.
Okay.
I think Jamaicans would like him. Let's give it a try.
This time out of South Africa comes a brother with an album called The House of Exile. Indeed, another hit recording is called Prisoner. Another one that says, I've got you, babe. Together as one, let's welcome to Jamaica and to Reggae Sun Splash 92. Let's hear it for Lucky Dube.
And my friend, we had no idea. We had no idea what we were in for.
Yeah.
When Lucky hit the stage, the staff stopped working, the gate people stopped working. The place came to a total halt because we had never seen anything like it. And we knew the music was good, but we had never seen a performance like that. It was absolutely, totally mesmerizing, you know?
Yeah.
And I just stood at the side of the stage, speechless.
When Lucky
heritage.
Came on stage and started, it was electrifying. That is the only word to describe. The atmosphere in the park. He tore the place down. It was amazing because it was really the first serious African act that ever came to Sunspot. And it was just so wonderful to have them here. It opened up Jamaica's eyes to Africa and African.
I think you met Sister Marcia.
Yes,
Marcia
did.
Griffiths. There she is. In full flow. This photograph was taken in 1977 or 78, when there was serious gang warfare and political warfare going on in Jamaica, and Bob decided to do a peace concert. I was a volunteer in that concert, you know, and it's one of those things I never really forget. This was a fantastic concert. And what Bob did was, he brought on stage both sides, you know, both the henchmen from the political sides, the real bad guys. Yeah. And then when he was finished, he brought the Prime Minister, Michael Manley, and the leader of the opposition, Edward Seago, and he brought them together. He pulled them up together and made them hold hands and declare peace to the Jamaican people. A very historical moment, you know. The spirit of Lucky kind of belongs in this historical setting, you know, and it's really, it's right.
Ukubona le museum and just the way aba preserve ngayo I memory of Bob Marley, you know, to me now there was something to look to bone good nami. This is something that maybe in the future nami ngabheka ukuthi ngiyenzele for ubaba, because I think on the global on the international scale, ubaba naye he was one of those people at the air recognized, yabo, and I think he deserves as much, yabo.
Everybody here, we are slaves till Africa and Africans are free. Prisoner slave. Nobody can stop reggae. Reggae is strong. Spirit of hope.
Yeah, respect.
Respect.
Yeah, for the first time I met your father, I was in Boston, a show with Black Uru, and he was opening. But we always appreciate and love his music very much, you know. And when we got a chance to see him perform, I think it was very, very, very good, you know. So when we heard the news, I was driving, coming around here, Rory Carr said, Lucky Dube is dead. I said, no, man. He said, yeah. And just heard the news. So I came and I saw it on the television that he was dead.
It's a part of life, you know, things happen.
Well, I mean, for us, he's not dead because the music, his music still lives on, it still plays on the radio out here.
Yeah.
So, he'll be remembered for the work he has done.
I can't leave this Western kind of life. I'm packing up and I'm leaving on the next flight. Going to
I've got Lena, Lucky Dube's manager.
Nice to meet you.
And this is Thokozani, Lucky Dube's son.
Yes, blessed. Big man. Yeah, enough respect to them, man. Because when the man come my yard, them flex amongst all of we as artists and musicians and people in the studio, make good music. Yeah, and we endorse them just the same. Them man, they big and can't stop big. Yeah, right now we just want big up South Africa and bless up all of the family of Lucky Dube. I know it's a caveman, stand with the family. Yeah, in condolences, you know.
Final day in Jamaica, you know, so we have a few little more grounds to cover.
Yeah, Paul Bogle is one of the man them who fight. See this picture here? That's Paul Bogle here. That's the man. As you see the connection as we start talk about him?
Yeah.
That's Paul Bogle. That man was the man who stand up in St. Thomas and fight for the people's right. Is the man who said black people need to be free. And the Queen of England catch him and hung him.
Yeah, and this is where it's all started, where Paul Bogle take up the thing in his hand and say, listen, my man, we need to listen to the people. So they were having court and going out with them big congregation, and Paul Bogle marched from a place called Spring Yard, come to this area to talk to the judge and the high priest and whatever. They wouldn't listen to him. Yeah. They run him away. So he go back and group up, come back here, burn this down to the ground. You know?
So this was the courthouse?
Yeah, this is where they used to hang people. You know, try people, send them to prison, everything that is bad.
Well, so far, it's a scary place. I mean, they used to hang people here, shoot ships down with this, you know, and it's scary. It has an eerie feeling to this place.
Jamaica and Lucky's story, being told from here, you know, to me, it's not just one of those stories. There's a divine connection. And I'll tell you why, because Lucky had not been here in a very, very long time. But for some odd reason this year, he was invited to open the Cricket World Cup. And we see him at the same time, you know, being killed, you know, a few months after he'd been to Jamaica.
There's a spiritual connection to black people everywhere, so we go through the same struggle. We have the same pain. So all we need to do is just unite and come together. Your pain is mine and my pain is yours.
Back in South Africa, home that is. I mean, it's great to be back, you know, after the long flights, tired and everything. But I hope over the next couple of days it will wear off.
So Prophet is here.
Yeah.
He's come to do his thing,
yeah.
You know. So John is here. My boy Wem is here. And of course, Teresa is here. So they're all here. And we're gonna come in, you know, obviously a song, beautiful song, done by the one and only Prophecy in honor of the late Lucky Dube.
You know, an initiative like this that takes a young artist out of Jamaica to come through to South Africa and work with South African artists and trying to bridge the gap between, you know, the continent and the diaspora, you know, it's initiatives that we need to see happening. Reggae music was a part of our everyday life, you know, in townships and villages. But since we've achieved liberation, you know, it's like we don't want to hear the voices that come with the sound of reggae. Metro FM, the ultimate midday experience. The met of Lucky Dube, an international reggae superstar in our country, was felt far and wide. In one instance, a band in Jamaica composes a song dedicated to Lucky Dube. The song asks pertinent questions about violence and its consequences, and it also sends a warm condolence to the Dube family that says, in short, your pain is our pain. Joining me in the studio to tell me more about that is a voice of the people, for the people, a voice of the future, a voice of hope and selflessness. I'm talking about Prophecy. So what made you decide to work on the song Chance, a tribute to Lucky Dube, and come all the way to South Africa to come actually be part of this project that you guys are involved in?
No matter where you come from, as long as you're a black man, you're African, you know.
As a Rastafari, still, yeah, we kind of know our roots and know that we are African heritage. You know, the mourning of Lucky Dube is really a sad one, but you know, we have us to do this.
Hi!
Wow!
This is Prophecy.
Hi, Ray White.
Good to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Hi, good to meet you.
How can we stop such violence from happening? How do we stop it? How can we? What sort of a peaceful way of life can we come up with? How would you do it?
Yeah, to infiltrate music, you know, because, you know, there are so much sectors doing what they can do, but we as musicians, yeah, mm-hmm. we tend to do it our own way, yeah? So we have music, so we present music.
Okay.
So this is what we do.
Prophecy, a message to the people of South Africa. The nation's listening.
Hold on to ourselves, man, because we're all we've got.
I just want to tell you, just preserve. Let us try and preserve ourselves, you know, because we are all we got, you know. Stop killing our one another. Stop killing our prophet. You cannot take out a man like Lucky Dube.
Absolutely.
This man, you know, oh God, man. You cannot do that. So preserve this man. Preserve. Let's preserve ourselves, all right?
You'd never be able to reproduce or be your father, but be his son.
Yeah.
And that is what will take you through.
Definitely it was a healing journey, a very healing journey. You know, it got me to accept that he's gone, you know, in physical, you know, he's gone, but his music lives on, you know, the message in his music lives on. So that will always be there for us to remember him, you know. So he left us something in the air.
So you better get right. Oh, it's gonna rain. It's gonna rain. You better get ready.
I'm doing it. We're doing the third song now.
That song,
them wrong.
We're so good. You know, we haven't got much time, but you know, these people are good. They know their stuff.
Thank you.
tonight at the showground. Some more like divine feelings mixed with emotion now, yeah? Because we know just in moments we're going to be sharing a moment with people who within their heart suffer the loss of Lucky Dube, you know? So it's just like a house of mourners.
Jamaicans and Africans, it's about time you come together. Jamaicans and Africans, it's about time you come together. Together as one.
Now, Massive and Crew, we have live on stage, original, official, Lucky Dube band striking up the music. So, Massive and Crew, enjoy the show. Enjoy the Lucky Dube band. Take it away. Yeah.
I think the passing of Lucky Dube, you know, in a certain way, you know, shall not work mysteriously. I think this is gonna make things to start happening for reggae. Because for a long time, you know, radio stations and TV, they've been fighting, you know, like down tracing reggae music.
Yo.
I have to make a money for my family, alleviate the poverty, try to keep a good man down. We're not ready for this. Play me low. Yo, Massive. They killed Lucky Dube just the other day. And them say them a bad man. And they rob poor people. Hear the lyrics right now. Yeah, bounce, man. Give me the mix. Hey, hi. It's getting so crazy. How we go? They want to rob poor people. I see them, they want to rob poor people. I see them, they want to rob poor people. Think they have the keys to the city. Look how it go get sticky in the city. Rob poor people, they think they have the keys to the city. How we go?
Because Lucky Dube is my brother. So this is his daughter. His daughter is my daughter. Her name is Kunulego. Hold on. She's gonna toast it for you. She's gonna do it for you. Come on, sister.
Yeah. Yeah. Yes, I know me, Sammy, can I be for my sinner? Make a sinner, shinner, sinner, be for my sinner. Watch your faith, Sammy, can I see no sinner? Watch your dust, Sammy, can I be my silver? Watch your people, Sibba, Shama, can I see no sinner? Come here, Sammy, can I see no sinner? Watch your feel, on me, Shama, keep proof for sinner. Watch your Sabbathaya, Rastafari.
I agree to be loved, South Africa. Rastafari. Well, the journey continues in South Africa, and I. Just the roundness of it, still an advocate, you know, what Lucky Dube left off, so. Right now we have STEM, crime and violence.
Da 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 da. So
much going down. Africa, I felt your pain knowing that Lucky Dube has gone. Nations cry aloud and his name I hear they echo. I wonder why such great man not to go. Give us a chance and let us live.
Give us a chance, give us a chance.
Give us a chance and we will make it.
Give us a chance, give us a chance.
Give us a chance and let us free. Give us a chance and we will make it. My people, you better run. Let's take a look down here in home. Problems we face down here in our kingdom. We're even rampant in the streets of the ghetto. I'm wondering why the gunmen and the guns won't go. Give us a chance to live. Give us a chance and we will make it, make it. Give us a chance to live. Give us a chance and we will make it. My people, you better run, you better take over. Da 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 da. Tension rise, down upon the surface. Moving with my little ray of hope. Tied in your eye, I'll be surfing. Weary, but I know we've got to come. We can make it, sure we can make it.
Prophecy that come talk about Lucky Dube. Right now we here go tell you. Now we demand the lab bridge. And we rockety jockety shooting video. Yeah. We go nice it up, make the wall like you deaf in.
Yeah, my name is Josh Seed. Right now we are shooting the video commemorate thing Lucky Dube, a warrior from Africa. Spread reggae music. We have Africans from Jamaica who are back home red helping us. Singing on this tune here right now, yeah man, is a must. And it's a unity, unity vibe, unity is a must. How it was in the beginning, so must it be in the end. Africans are back in Africa, yeah man.
Give us a chance and let us live. Give us a chance and we will make it, make it. Give us a chance and let us free.
Everybody within the reggae industry in Jamaica, I want South Africa to know, so we all mourn the loss of such a great icon. So it's always a pleasure for I and I to come to the forefront of things and also extend I and I condolence.
Action!
It's quite amazing that it's happening, that artists from Jamaica are actually reaching out to us musically and culturally, you know. And it is said that it had to happen with Lucky Dube's death, you know, but I believe that Africans must unite.
Across the ocean.
I've learned a lot of lessons at different stages in my life from Ubaba. And one of the things that I can highlight is that he used to tell me that he didn't have the opportunity to go to further his studies beyond matric, and that I should take that opportunity, you know, to study on further and do what I can do and be something, you know. And basically, at times I would call him, you know, and tell him, "Esh, these tests are hectic or whatever," and he'll just laugh it off and tell me that hard work is the mother of success, you know. So from that, now that is gone, I actually realize that hard work really is the mother of success, because now I actually have to work hard.
Da 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 da. So much going down. Africa, I felt your pain, knowing that Lucky Dube has gone. Nations cry aloud and his name I hear echo. I wonder why so.
Yeah, well, I just wanted to give you a little something, you know, to take back to Jamaica with you, you know. Well, let me just explain these CDs first of all. This one is Serious Reggae Business.
Good.
I think it was done in 96. Yes, it was done in 96.
Good.
It's one of my favorites, actually, but yeah. I did the same to you.
Thank you.
It's a humbling experience and a humbling feeling.
Awesome. Yeah.
You know, so I thank you all for having me here. And the trip was really wonderful.
Guidance, give thanks.
Yeah,
man.
Yeah, I must also use Lucky Dube's word. In whatever you do, please remember me. And whatever I do, I remember you, South Africa.
Ubaba, according to me, was very wise. You know, you could get out of situations that you thought, okay, like this is it, this is the dead end. You know, and he would come up with something, you know. So if I had to ask him, you know, it would be for him to guide me, you know. Divine power, you know, give me some divine power or something, you know, just to guide me.